Good morning, students. Today, my next topic after tRNA, which I have completed in the previous class, is translation. We all know that translation means synthesis of protein from RNA. Now, we go in detail about the process of translation. Okay? Now, what is translation? The process by which, what is translation? The process by which the triplet coding sequence, yeah, triplet base sequence is called codon in genetic code. The process by which the triplet base sequence on messenger RNA guides the linking. The process by which the triplet base sequence on messenger RNA guides the linking of what? Specific sequences of amino acids. Guides the linking of specific sequences of amino acids to form polypeptide. To form polypeptide. Where? On a ribosome. Okay. is known as translation. So what is translation? The process, okay, by which the triplet base sequence, TBS, triplet base sequence, that is codon on mRNA, guides the linking of specific sequences, of amino acids. Why? To form polypeptide chain. Polypeptide chain means protein, where on a ribosome is known as translation. That is the definition of translation. Now, let's come to know the second point, that is translation machinery. Translation machinery. Translation require a machinery. Okay. Translation requires a machinery. Means it requires a system. Okay. Which consists of प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस के लिए सबसे वाला नीड क्या है? राइबोसोम. सेकेंड एमआरएनए, बिकॉज एमआरएनए कंटेन द मैसेज दैट विच टाइप ऑफ प्रोटीन इज टू बी सिंथेसाइज बाय राइबोसोम. ओके, नेक्स्ट एमआरएनए, टीआरएनए दैट इज ट्रांसफर आरएनए. नाउ एमिनो एसाइल tRNA synthetase, amino acyl tRNA synthetase. Okay, this is the enzyme amino acyl tRNA synthetase. What is this? This is an enzyme that helps. This is an enzyme that helps in what? in combining amino acids in combining amino acid to particular tRNA. Okay, first machinery is ribosome, second is mRNA, third is transfer RNA, fourth is aminoacyl tRNA synthetase, that is it is an enzyme that helps to bind ribosome with transfer RNA and amino acids. Why? Because this is the raw material for translation process. Now initiation tRNA. Initiation tRNA. Initiation tRNA. What is this initiation tRNA? It is a specific tRNA. It is the specific tRNA. ये एक specific tRNA है for the process of initiation. ये एक specific tRNA है किसके लिए? For the process of initiation. And there are no tRNA for stop codon. और stop codon के लिए कोई tRNA नहीं है. What is initiation tRNA? It is a specific tRNA for the process of initiation. Initiation का मतलब होता है to start the protein synthesis, that is translation. Now the third, that is mRNA हो गया, that is ribosome. Because we all know ribosome को हम क्या बोलते हैं? Protein factory. तो बिना ribosome के protein हो ही नहीं सकता है. ठीक है? Ribosome. Ribosome. Okay. Now, ribosome is responsible for protein synthesis, and it consists of a structural RNA and around 80 different protein. It is responsible for. It is responsible for what? Protein synthesis. It is responsible for protein synthesis. It is responsible for protein synthesis. It consists of. It consists of structural RNA. It consists of structural RNA and around 80 different protein. 80 different protein. That is the chemical composition of ribosome. First of all, it is responsible for protein synthesis. It consists of structural RNA and around 80 different protein. Okay, now protein exists as two subunit in its inactive stage. Jab inactive hota hai, when ribosome is not responsible for or not involved in protein synthesis, then ribosome is found in dissociated state, and that is called its inactivated stage. Okay, now ribosome, that is protein factory, exists as two subunit in its inactive stage, in its inactive stage. Ribosome exists as two subunits in its inactive stage. Now we must know both smaller subunit and larger subunit of ribosome. Okay, first is small subunit, smaller subunit of ribosome. Smaller subunit of ribosome. Now, when the smaller subunit of ribosome, that is, it is 30S in case of prokaryote and 40S in case of eukaryote, encounter an mRNA, translation of mRNA to protein begins. Okay, when the smaller subunit, when the smaller subunit, that is 40S eukaryote or 30S prokaryote, when the smaller subunit encounter an mRNA, encounter an mRNA, it associate with mRNA and translation of mRNA to translation of mRNA to protein begins. Translation of mRNA to protein begins. Now let's come to the second, that is larger subunit of RNA. Larger subunit of ribosome. Larger subunit kya hai? Prokaryote or eukaryote mein differ karega? इसमें क्या होगा? इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस. ये तो हम सब जानते हैं क्योंकि राइबोसोम का दोनों यूनिट मिलकर ही प्रोटीन को सिंथेसाइज करता है. नाउ इट इज 60S यूकैरियोट और 50S प्रोकैरियोट. ये 60S का होता है यूकैरियोटिक सेल में और 50S का होता है प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल में. ओके, नाउ इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू साइट्स वेयर amino acid, it consists of two sites, that is A site and P sites, where amino acid can bind to, जहां पे amino acid एक दूसरे के साथ bind करेगा and be automatic है कि जब bind करेगा तो एक दूसरे के नजदीक आएगा and be close to each other for the formation of what? For the formation of peptide bond. for the formation of peptide bond. So it has or these two subunits, whether it is 60 or 50 of larger subunit, consist of two sites, that is A and P site, where amino acid can bind to and be close to each other for the formation of peptide bond. Now ribosome also acts as a catalyst. Ribosome also acts as a catalyst. That means it is reactive. How? Catalyst 23S, ribosomal RNA, ribosomal RNA in bacteria. 23S ribosomal RNA in bacteria has the enzyme, okay, is the enzyme ribozyme. For what? For peptide bond formation. For peptide bond formation. And when multiple peptide bond is formed, it is called polypeptide chain, and this polypeptide chain is called protein. So that is all about ribosome. It is responsible for protein synthesis. It consists of structural RNA and 18 different type of protein. Ribosome exists as two subunit in dissociated state when it is in inactive state. Now one is smaller subunit and one is larger subunit. The smaller subunit is 30S in case of prokaryote and 40S in case of eukaryote. And when it is in contact with mRNA, the protein synthesis begins. Now the larger subunit, it is 60S in eukaryote and 50S in prokaryote. It consists of two sites, that is A site and P site, where amino acid can bind to and close to each other to form a peptide bond. Now ribosome also acts as a catalyst. Example, 23S ribosomal RNA in bacteria is having the enzyme ribozyme for peptide bond formation. So that is all about the ribosome, which is one of the very important machinery components of translation process. Now let's come to the next. Next thing, translational unit या translation unit, translation unit. It is also one of the components of machinery system of translation. Okay, it is the sequence of RNA. Translation unit is a sequence of RNA flanked by, यानी घिरा हुआ है, by start codon on one side and stop codon on the another. It is the, that is translation unit is the sequence of RNA flanked by the start codon, that means either AUG or GUG. We all know that AUG codes for methionine and GUG codes for valine. Okay, by the start codon on one side and the stop codon means either UAA और UAG और UGA on one side and the stop codon on the other side. On the other side. Now it means translation unit. It codes for a polypeptide. It codes for a polypeptide that has to be produced. It codes for a polypeptide that has to be produced. That is called translational unit. Now another is UTR. In NCERT book it is found untranslated regions UTRS untranslated region. Okay, what is next? These are some additional sequences in the mRNA. Okay, these are some additional sequences in the mRNA. These are some additional sequences in the mRNA that are not translated. इसको translate किया नहीं जाता, यानी जिससे protein नहीं बनाया जा सकता है. और ये एक तरफ stop signal के पहले होता है और दूसरे तरफ start signal के पहले होता है. ठीक है, they means untranslated region are present at both the ends, that is at 5' end, that is at 5' end before start codon and at 3' end and at 3' end after stop codon and at 3' end after stop codon. These improve the efficiency. These improve the efficiency of translation process. Okay, so untranslated region be clear. These are some additional sequences in the mRNA that are not translated, means that are not involved in protein synthesis. It is found at both the ends, that is at 5' end before start codon and at 3' end after stop codon. This improves the efficiency of the translation process. So these all are involved in the translation machinery system. Okay, that's all for today. In the next class we go through the process, that is how the translation process takes place. That's all for today. Have a nice day. Thank you.